Good morning, folks. My name's Steve. This is going to be my first flight with some speaking, so I apologise in advance if there is any glaring errors. Okay, today's flight will be in the Aerosoft Airbus 319 from Gatwick to Inverness. Flight number EZY865. We're currently at gate 58 at Gatwick, and it's around 6:45 AM on Sunday the 10th of July. Our flight plan this morning has us taking off actually on 26 right from Gatwick, which should be 26 left, and arriving in Inverness runway 23. We're going to be carrying 125 passengers, which gives us a zero fuel weight of 52 tons, a takeoff weight of 59 tons. It will be a Flex 67 takeoff from 26 left. Our fuel we're going to require for the flight is 6.7 tons, and our routing today is going to take us away from Gatwick on a Lamborn 4 Mike departure to a Barkway. Sorry, Brookmans Park, and then northwest up through the Midlands to just north of Glasgow, where we'll join November 560 with an arrival in Inverness, probably using the Category C arrival for runway 23. So we'll just nip into the cockpit and get things prepared. Should point out, incidentally, before we get going, that I am using two computers at the moment. I've got the flight sim, which is running on an i5 with a 32-inch screen. I've also got a notepad, which is running my EFB, ACARS, and ActiveSky Next. And I have also got a tablet, which is running my FMC. Just having a little bit of a problem getting my FMC on the tablet to speak to the computer. Let's have another go. Okay. So we might have to go and do this the old fashioned way. We've got it. Here we go. So, what you'll notice at the moment is some various changes happening on the left-hand flight management computer. Once we get the fuel and the payload sorted out. I'll just nip over to the laptop, pull up my flight plan, and we're needing 6.7 tons of fuel. I didn't put any cargo in, so I'll put 0.1 of cargo, and we're going to be carrying approximately 125 people. I'll just load that up instantly. Instant load. Okay, that's that done. Better turn the radios on and tune in to Unicom as we're live on VATSIM. I have actually loaded a flight plan and submitted it on VATSIM, so there's a chance on a Sunday morning that one or two guys do come on. So I'm all prepared. Okay. Let's go. So I'm now on the tablet, and you'll notice the FMC will be changing as I make changes on the tablet. So our company route is EGKK EGPE 01, which gives us our routing automatically from the flight planning software. Our flight number is EZY 865. I'll stick a cost index of 22 down on our flight level 380, I think. Let's just quickly check that. Flight level 380. Our fuel on board is a block of 6.7. Our flight plan has us going off on 26 right, which is wrong. That should be 26 left on a Lamborn 4 Mike. And we will be coming in to Inverness on runway. What's that? Get rid of that. Runway 23, hopefully. Next waypoint, INS. Okay, and we'll now arrival ILS 23. Okay. So that's what I should have sorted that problem out with the flight plan. Nope. Get rid of that flight discontinuity out of there. Okay. Our preferences page will be a flaps 1 takeoff. Now I'm going to be using a flex off 67 according to our flight plan, which should give me V speeds off 140, 140. And 140 and 141. Transition altitude is 6,000 feet. Now, let's grab some weather information for our destination from Active Sky Next. QNH is 997. Temperature at this time of the day is 15 and the wind is 240/10. Transition altitude at Inverness is 3,000 feet and that is us. Pretty good. Now while we're here we'll just get our departure weather. Our QNH is 1010. We'll set that. Close that down. And if we go to our autopilot, we can prepare that as well. So V1 is 141, so if I go for 151, our heading for runway 26 right, didn't work, 250. Our heading is about, well, set for 260 at the moment. Our initial altitude on the departure plate for a Longbourn 4 Mike is 6,000 feet. Okay. Sorry about that. Problem with the microphone. We're still good. I can turn this thing down a little bit. Okay. Okay, that's all still sitting pretty. No ATC on, so I'm going to go for a squawk off 2200 and we'll just have a quick look about, make sure we're all okay, hit the beacon and start the APU. We can get rid of the jetway and we can shut the door. actually has our landing light on for some strange reason. Oh, that's it now. It's now just gone 7 a.m. I'm just looking at my EFB on the other computer. There's a couple of flights at Gatwick. One of them is departing, the other one is sitting at a stand. So, we'll call up our ground crew. Push back and departure by EasyJet. And nose right. Okay, here goes.
Departure check completed. Bypass bit inserted. Release parking brakes. Commencing push. All engines clear. Start at will. Clear.
listening, we have got what looks like a Delta 777 passing us on our right. Anyway, without any further ado, we will get going. That's all the pre-flight prep carried out, so yeah, off to 26 left we go. Traffic about Gatwick this morning. More coffee is required. Like we've gone the wrong way up taxiway Alpha November, but hey-ho. Looks like we've got Air Europa in front of us. Wonder who he's off to, probably sunnier climates. Apparently we've got a VAS monitor running on the machine as well. VAS at the moment is sitting at 3. It's a little higher than I thought, but there's quite a lot of clouds about. Okay, we'll go for light up strobes. Spotted on. depart here, which is say Alpha November to Alpha 1. Once this chap gets out of the way, we'll be ready to go. Okay, all good. Let's go.
Approaching 2-6 left.
For a rolling start.
On runway 2-6 left.
was going to consider going straight up to flight level 380, but I'm noticing the traffic that departed in front of me is actually flying the same SID as myself, so, and there is some traffic roundabout within 20 miles, so I think I'll hang fire on the SID just for the moment. Okay, how are we getting on? We are clear of any traffic that's heading towards us, so I think what we'll do once we pass Acorn, I'll start my ascent up to flight level 380. Quite not a bad morning over the south of England. I'm using the Active Sky Next for the weather generation along with Soft Clouds 2. I've also managed to tweak some shaders, which if you follow my mouse up there up towards the Thames estuary, it's causing some nice shading of the clouds above the ground. There are some various programs about things, but I just did a very simple tweak that I found on Facebook. Just notified my intentions on the software that I use to connect to VATSIM, which is VPilot. I don't I am now going to start my climb. Initially, I'll set it at 2,100 feet a minute. Standard pressure, and then once I get out of the range of the SID, I will put it on to automatic and do a managed mode. One or two stutters this morning, specifically on the recording software. I don't know if this will actually come through on the video or not, but we'll see. This is only my fourth video, so I am still playing about with settings, so hopefully I can get it right.